Hello friends, welcome to today's class. So in continuation with the previous class wherein we studied our MSC error surface and its geometry, today we will go ahead with the next important topic, which is steepest descent search with exact gradient information. So here it is, in short it is called a steepest descent algorithm, right? So before understanding or before going through this steepest descent algorithm, we would like to brush upon some things which we studied in our previous class, which is MSC error surface. So what did we see in the previous class? We came across an equation called as Wiener-Hof system, right? And we tried to find its solution. Now what was it actually? To explain you in short, so this was the thing. What did we got here? It is nothing but minus of p plus r into w cap. What is this minus of p plus r into w cap? This minus of p is one such vector and r is also the other vector. What is minus of p? Minus of p is nothing but your cross correlation and r is nothing but your autocorrelation, and w cap is, as you have seen, it is weight updation, right? Now our aim in the steepest descent algorithm is to find the solution for this Wiener equation or Wiener system. What is Wiener system? Wiener system is nothing but your minus of p plus r into w cap, or you can say r into w cap, which is equal to p. Now how to find the solution for this? We already know some methods to find the solutions. If you remember, we have already went through some of the things wherein we try to find the solution. The best method to find the solution to any equations, or in general, how do you get the solution in your ANN? It is by nothing but your weight updation. That is, we go on changing our weights. How do we change the weights? By each and every iteration. We take the, we assume certain weight, then we, after that, we iterate it n number of times and we go on updating the weights after n number of iteration. Right now, this algorithm, that is a steepest descent algorithm, is one such algorithm which is totally depending on your MSC error surface. That is, it will try to find out the solution for this Wiener-Hof system. Okay, now how it tries to find out? It tries to use your gradient information, the information which you have already seen in your mean square error surface, wherein we use it to search in weight space. Now in order to understand this, what we'll do is we'll see a small graph, which you can see here. It is a plot of your omega ik with respect to epsilon. So here we will plot your omega ik with respect to epsilon. Epsilon, you can see here, I have written epsilon. Omega ik was missing, so therefore I have written here omega ik. So we'll be plotting this graph, and this graph is in your epsilon minus omega ik plane. Okay, so please observe this graph very carefully, because the whole thing is depending on this graph. How to understand this whole graph? If you understand this whole graph, then you will easily understand your steepest descent algorithm. Now why is this graph used? Now this graph is used to find the minimum error. We'd like to find the minimum error. Now where this minimum error occurs? This minimum error occurs at the position omega I cap. So you have a omega I k cap here, this omega I cap. So you can find out the error. Error is nothing but your y axis. You can see here in the y axis. Now where is error minimum? The error goes on reducing, something like this, and it reaches a minimum point here. Then after some time it again goes on increasing. So this is nothing but your gradient information. That means our minimum error is present at the position omega of I cap. Okay, now what is the next very important thing? How to find out this error then? This minimum error, now you can see there are two points. One is omega I1 of k and another one is omega I2 of k. So now that means our omega I of k may be present at any one of these two locations. It may be present even at omega I of k cap, no doubt. If it is present of if it is present at omega I of cap, then no doubt, no need to make any changes. You directly say that our error is minimum at the position omega I of cap. Now let us assume that our error is at omega, is towards omega I1 of k. That is, I mean to say, omega I of k is somewhere near omega I1 of k. That is something like this. it is here. Say your omega I of k is somewhere here. That means what I need to do in such condition? In such a condition, we need to move our omega I of k, which is our orange line right now, towards omega I cap. Right? That means what now? We need to move our omega I of k towards omega I cap so that it becomes a minimum. Now, if it is towards your omega I1 of k, that means it is clearly a negative value. So that means the error gradient here is negative. Now let us assume that your omega I of k is towards here, that is at the omega I2 of k. So somewhere here, I will say that this is your omega I of k. So if my omega I of k is somewhere here, then we say that it is towards the positive end. Now where I should move your omega I of k? I should move your omega I of k towards omega I cap. So that means we need to decrease your omega I of k so that it reaches omega I cap. What did we do in the previous case? In the previous case, we tried to increase our omega I of k so that it reaches omega I cap. So when it is near omega I2 of k, the gradient is positive. Remember, the error gradient when it is towards omega I1 of k, it is negative. When it is near omega I2 of k, it is positive. And when it is near omega I1 of k, we should move it towards what now? Towards omega I cap. So therefore, we need to decrease our omega I of k. So is that clear? I hope this is clear. Moving ahead, we'll move to the next slide wherein I have written all these informations. Okay. So this is our next slide wherein I have written. So what we need to do here now? The minimum error occurs at where? It occurs at W of I cap. So therefore, the weight has to be moved. Now, where do we move the weight? The weight is moved depending on where is your omega I of k. So at omega I1 of k, you can observe here, it is error gradient is negative. And at omega I2 of k, the error gradient is positive. So this whole thing can be summarized with the help of a simple equation, something like this. So here you can see the gradient is nothing but what now? Error gradient is nothing but it is the differentiation of your error with respect to weight. That is what we have written here. Dou of error, that is epsilon, divided by dou of wik. If it is greater than 0, it means that omega ik is greater than omega I cap. And we need to decrease our omega ik. Okay, so this is in case when it is positive. And the second case is what? When it is negative, when it is less than 0. Less than 0, it means what now? It is negative. If it is negative, what we need to do? We need to increase our omega I of k. So please try to understand this, friends. If you understood this whole graph, then the whole thing becomes very simple. Depending on this, the next topic is totally dependent. Like how this topic is dependent on your MSE error surface, the next topic is dependent on your steepest descent algorithm. Now, moving ahead. So therefore, logically, we can write that weight component should be updated in proportion with the negative of gradient. That means as the gradient becomes negative, our weight component goes on updating. It means that you can observe clearly in our equation what we have written. What is the weight updation thing? The weight updation is shown by what component? It is omega I of k plus 1. Here we are updating the weights. Then what we are doing here, how it is depending? Omega I of k is nothing but the present weight. Omega I of k plus 1 is nothing but the next weight. Yes. And then what is the, how it is? That means it is totally dependent on two things. Which is the first thing? Your eta. Which is the second important thing? Your minus of dou e of divided by dou wik. What is dou e divided by dou I? It is nothing but your gradient. Then how is this gradient? If you can observe here, how is this gradient? This gradient is a negative value. So therefore, we are saying that weight component should be updated in proportion with your minus of dou e by dou wik, which is negative of gradient. The same thing can be written in the form of a vector wherein we replace our small w's by capital W's. That's all. So w of k plus 1 is w of k plus eta minus dou e by dou I of k. What is dou e by dou wi of k? It is nothing but minus of del epsilon. So This is very important, friends. So what we did right now, we have updated our weights. We have got our weight updation equation, which we were not having in your MSc. So remember, friends, weight updation equation is very important. Based on this, we'll try to get the next topic, which is your mu LMS algorithm. That is, this mu LMS is totally dependent on your gradient descent. That is your steepest descent. Okay, from steepest descent we'll move to gradient descent. Okay, so thank you, friends. We'll see the rest of the things in the next class. Go through the whole derivation. If you have any doubts, you can call me or WhatsApp me. Thank you.